Blackstone presents Neon Redemption by V.K. Fox. This book is read by Chelsea Stevens. For Drew, because you loved the neon. Prologue, 2 years ago. Let's get out of here. Olive Balm jammed her slender practice blade in the rack and glanced casually over her shoulder. Her tank top was stained with sweat. Dirt and grass stuck to her dark, muscular arms. A long patch of turf burn on the back of her thigh was inflamed at the edge of her cutoffs. She'd yelled at him to go harder. Nice to see she wasn't pouting over it now. A few remaining pledges were wrapping up their field drills in the chilly late afternoon sunshine. Dahl was a similar mess. However hard he'd pushed, she'd come right back. She'd fought like a wolverine, not bothering to pull her blows. Olive was a dozen years his senior, but she didn't seem older, just better. You don't want an encore. She'd better not. Dahl hurt from shins to shoulders. Only half of his smarting welts were on generally accepted targets for this kind of informal workout. It was his turn to cook tonight, and his new medication regime made him jittery and distracted. A sublime, perfect evening was a hot shower, a quick dinner, and a good book. His lovely commanding officer was going through a rough patch, but he didn't want to physically absorb it. Her body language as she turned was more primal, more physically deliberate. Do you have plans tonight? Dahl shrugged. Maybe. He finished putting up his equipment and grabbed a towel from the bin, rubbing the sweat out of his short blonde hair. What did you have in mind? Motorcycle or Mustang? She owned the bike. He owned the car. They were going out. You drive. Olive's grin widened, contrasting bright teeth against impetuously plumb lips. She grabbed her keys from the pegboard and strode towards the lot. Assuming things about a social outing with an intensely impulsive divorcee was a fool's game. Time for a shower, clean clothing, and a helmet was not included. Dahl held her waist as they sped along the highway, out of the city towards the mountains. She smelled like sweat and felt like part of the machine, allotting only an easy non-concentration to propel them forward at 110 miles per hour. Freezing wind whipped by as Dahl held her, warm and solid. It was like flying. Off the highway, she easily doubled the limit on twisting country roads in the foothills. Thank God they were paved. They pulled into a small lot near a trailhead. She kicked her leg over the parked bike, turned, and kissed him. No discussion, no nerves, and no preamble. Unless the hour of clinging to her in transit counted. It was right. Everything was harmonizing, and their song might be in time with the minute waltz, but the moment was now, and they both knew it. Olive pressed against him with the same ferocity he'd felt on the practice field. This moment, infinitely preferable to getting beaten with a blunted sword. It was their first kiss, and it lasted longer than every other kiss in his life combined, stealing the breath from his lungs and pushing the blood through his veins. She pulled away, jogging up the trail. Breathless and inviting pursuit, an ineffable hook in his heart. This was life, all 5 feet 6 inches of it in Doc Martens and wide, dark eyes. Dahl couldn't recover the lost breath. It belonged to her now, rightfully stolen. He was after her in an instant. After half a mile, Olive stopped running. She was so fast that even with the promise of what might transpire when he caught up, it took him 10 full seconds to close the distance. Dahl pulled up a few feet short and watched her search the edge of the trail, glancing briefly at trees and rocks. The run had returned both of them to a sweat-drenched state. It was twilight, and markers would be hard to see. Are you looking for something? He patted his pockets for cigarettes, which were in his coat at the practice field.
There's an off-trail waterfall. I wanted to swim.
She looked at him with meaning. Dahl summoned all the self-control in his body and shook his head.
This is a place you know, yes?
Of course.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.